So these elements of image interpretation are very, very interesting. There are 8 major elements that we talk about, and those are the 8 that have been given here. Let's focus on those one by one. So first is the shape. It explains the outline. So with the outline, I can easily identify, let's say if it is a circle, I can say it's a well. If it is a square, I can say probably it is a house. If it is a long linear path, I can say it's a transport network, either a road or a railway. So shape depends on the outline of the object, and that helps us to understand what kind of object would be actually there. The size explains what it is relative to other. So a rural area versus an urban area, I can see more green patches in a rural area in contrast to an urban area. The size of the residential dwelling would vary. So the residential dwellings could be far apart in a rural area, but could be very, very clustered in the case of an urban settlement. And there is where we understand size. The next is the tone. Now, tone actually explains the brightness or the color. So, how smooth or what kind of surface is there explains the tone. Now, when I say if the surface is smooth, if the surface is dry, in that case, the amount of energy that would be reflected, which would be much more in comparison to a rough surface. So the amount of energy which is reflected from a smooth surface would be much higher as compared to a rough surface. So a healthy vegetation would be seen strongly in an infrared region, where you would have multiple layers of leaf structure that would be seen, and this would appear in light tone or bright tone based on the vegetation pattern that is there. But if the vegetation pattern, let's say, is a scrub, it would occur in the shades of gray. So that is how we understand the tone. So if it is light blue, light red color, then I would say it is a smooth vegetation that is there. But if it is scrubs that are around, that would be in the shades of gray. So that shows whether it is a smooth surface or a rough surface and the reflectance based on that. The next is the site or the location. Now, site is the location, and it helps us in actually understanding where the pattern is there. So when I say the site, it exactly tells me that this is the point where the industry is. So the exact site of an industrial location, of a mining location, could be explained through the image interpretation, where I can say this is the mining area that is seen. The next is texture. Texture explains how smooth or coarse the surface is. Now, under the tone, we were understanding this smoothness and the roughness with the reflectance and the color shades. Here, we are talking about the fine or the coarse gradient. So, let's say if it is a densely populated region, it would be much finer in the texture. However, if it is a low density area, it would be much coarse in the texture. So here what we feel is the texture, not the color. Under tone, we were understanding the color, and that is a very major difference. A lot of students get confused here. So be very particular. Tone focuses on the brightness, the hue, the color. However, texture focuses on whether it is coarse, whether it is smooth in finish, and that is what governs the texture. The next is shadow. Shadow helps us to determine the height. So let's say there is a big minaret, and then there would be the shadow of this minaret that would be seen, and the resulting area would be based on that. So let's say you are sighting an area just besides Qutub Minar. So that would be the case in the shadow. But however, in another case, you would have the shadows which would be very, very small if it is a simple small grassland vegetation that is seen. So shadow helps us to understand the height, and it helps us to identify the nearby features. Then we have association. Association helps us to create or interpret basically an image in a much smoother way. So let's say I explain that there are two important transport arteries going across one another, and then there is a densely populated region or a settlement. Then obviously this makes sense because there is an association, there is transport transport artery, and that transport artery would be cutting a region where there would be definitely people living. It won't go into jungles where there is no people. It won't carry the wild animals there. So what the idea is, we try to build an association which are of objects which are normally found together. And finally, we have a pattern. Pattern explains us the layout. So let's say if I take a picture of Chandigarh, probably I would see all the sectors that are clearly demarcated. Chandigarh, Gandhinagar are good examples for the same. So I would have a good pattern where I would say, okay, this is sector 57, this is sector 58, and each of the sectors are well demarcated one after the other, and this gives us a pattern. So these are the rows of the housing patterns that could be seen. And then when I understand it with overlapping it with the real ground map, I understand that these are the sectors that are defined, and a well drafted pattern is explained. So these eight elements are some of the most important basis for interpretation of a satellite imagery, where we understand the shape, the size, the texture, the tone, the location, the shadow association, and the pattern that is seen. Now, what kind of surface would convert into what color in a false color composite imagery? So when it is a vegetation or a covered area, it would convert into shades of red and brown. Evergreen would convert into red to magenta. Scrubs would convert into light patches of brown or gray with small red patches that would be there. Fallow land would be blue to white in color. However, a cropped area would be bright red in color. On the other hand, if it is a water body, the shades would vary from light blue to dark blue. If it is turbid, it would have light blue. If it is clear water, as we have seen, in that case, it would be very, very dark in color in a false color composite imagery. The built-up area would again be in the shades of bluish green and blue. And the waste areas, the wastelands, the outcrop areas would be in the shades of brown and white. If there are ravines, they would be in the shades of greens. And finally, the waterlogged areas or the wetlands would be in the shades of black. So those are some of the common shades that we see in a false color composite imagery. So this was about understanding the image. How do we actually interpret an image, and what are the things that we keep in back of mind while interpreting an image? We would try to associate the shape, the size, the color, the tone, the texture, and based on that, we would identify, overlap it with another Google map probably or another actual topo sheet, and then we would identify which area is what. And this is one of the basis for the forthcoming researches in your generation, definitely. So stay tuned for many more lectures from our side. Have a wonderful day ahead.